Deep brain stimulation is now being used to treat people with behavior disorders. That was the case for a Lancaster County man. His life is changed forever. Here's Travis Rohrer's journey. 27-year-old Travis Rohrer works part-time.
I work at Yoder's Country Market in New Holland, and I work in the frozen foods department.
Travis is also very active in his church.
I am a lector, but what you would normally call a lay reader, because that's what lector means. I'm one of them, not the only. I'm also one of the guys in charge of the lights in our church sanctuary, and I'm also one of the guys in charge of the ceiling fans that are in this church sanctuary.
This is Travis now. He's come a long way. Travis was diagnosed with autism when he was a child.
What led to that diagnosis was that we noticed as he approached his second birthday that he wasn't talking, he wasn't really playing with toys, he wasn't waving bye-bye, he wasn't interacting with people.
As Travis got older, he developed obsessive-compulsive disorder.
His particular obsession was with fans, any kind of fans, ceiling fans, window fans. And he became so obsessed that it just affected every aspect of his behavior. And it affected every aspect of his life and our family's life.
I just like the way the blade on the fan would, you know, spin, especially on hot days. That's what actually got me to like fans, because I just like seeing the blade spin, especially on hot days.
Robin did some research and learned deep brain stimulation could be used to treat OCD.
When I first met Travis, he was having a lot of trouble with obsessions. And they were really interfering with his life. And so really his life was turned totally upside down by the problems that he had.
Dr. McInerney is the first doctor that gave us any hope for having this procedure done. And he walked in the room and talked about the specifics of the surgery and how the procedure is done.
At first was nervous about it because especially I was afraid of spending overnight in the hospital by myself, but after mom told me that she would be with me every single second, especially overnight in the hospital, I was then open to it.
So we do this in a three-step process. The first step is a planning process where we, you know, get scans of his brain, MRI, CT scans, where we can measure everything out and figure out where we want to go. Second step, we go into the operating room, and that's the big brain operation where we actually implant the wires into the brain using the plans we made at the first step. We test them and make sure everything is working okay in there. And then we stop. And the last part of it is where we connect the wires to the battery and computer that runs everything. And then he's all hooked up and ready to go.
We had to wait about 3 to 4 weeks after the brain surgery. They have to wait until any brain swelling or inflammation goes down before they turn the battery on. And we noticed almost immediately after the battery was turned on that Travis's demeanor changed for the positive. He became more social. He was interacting more with us and talking more with us.
His mom was just overwhelmed, I think, was maybe a good way. I don't want to speak for her, but you know, in her conversation with me, she just couldn't believe how much easier it was for him to get through a day. It was just dramatically different.
Travis is well aware how a small device has made a huge difference in his life.
I'm doing a lot more things with my friends now than I was before the surgery.
Wow.
And it actually makes me feel great about it.
The success of this procedure has exceeded our greatest hopes. To see him living independently and going to work and having a life of his own was just something we never even could have imagined before. He's made such incredible progress. The results have just exceeded our wildest imagination.
And how does it make you feel that you were a part of this?
It's so humbling to be a part of, you know, watching somebody's story get to be closer to the rest of ours. To help somebody themselves get out of bed every morning with a purpose is just incredibly meaningful. And I'm just so very grateful to be able to help out that way.
My life has actually been a lot better since I had my surgery. Because before I had the surgery, I was just upset all the time. But after I had the surgery, I've actually felt a lot more happier.
And if you could say something to Dr. McInerney, what would you tell him?
I would say a thank you to him to make me feel more improved. So that's always a good sign.
Such a heartwarming story. Travis was on 15 different medications prior to the surgery. Now he's down to 5. What a difference it has made in his life. And joining us is Dr. Jim McInerney, Director of Stereotactic Neurosurgery at Penn State Health, and also Travis's surgeon. Do you need a tissue? What a difference. What a difference you made in his life. How does that make you feel?
It really is a special thing to be able to do. And I'm just very, as I said in the piece, I'm very grateful to be able to help anybody. But with Travis, it was, you know, it was a lot of work, but it was just so rewarding. And, you know, as I said, this is what, you know, makes us get out of bed every day. It's hard to describe the feeling, but I guess maybe I could say this is our Super Bowl.
Well, certainly he won the Super Bowl, that's for sure. Let's talk about the procedure. You mentioned it's a 3-step process. Talk to us a little bit more about it.
Sure. Well, the first part is really the planning part. There's a very little bit of surgery there. Put some screws in to measure with. That happens one day. Patients usually come back a week later for the implantation part, which is, you know, that's the brain operation. So that's a bigger deal. And we have to be very particular about getting these wires into the right target. They're very small targets. They're small wires. Testing them, making sure they're not having any side effects or anything. Once we get them in position, we finish for that day, and we watch those patients overnight. So that's the one night in the hospital that people usually spend. Then we bring them back a week later and hook those wires up to a little battery computer, the pulse generator, we call it, which is a same-day procedure, pretty quick. And they go home after that procedure's over.
Talk to us a little bit about the recovery.
Sure. So, you know, recovery, I don't think is too bad. As I said, it's one night in the hospital. It is a brain operation, so it's not nothing. And yet, I think most of our patients are able to go home and, regular, stay-at-home type routine things within the first week after surgery. Sometimes they feel a little cloudy in their thinking and stuff, but I think within probably a month at the outside, most people are pretty much back to doing normal things and doing what they need to do.
Some people may be watching wondering, could I be a candidate if I suffer from severe OCD?
Sure. Well, obviously we love to evaluate people. This is obviously not the thing that we do first, and we don't do a brain operation first for this, and people who come to us typically have been through an awful lot in terms of medication and therapy, trying to get this better. Oftentimes their psychiatrists have thought this was an option, but people have also reached out to us directly too, and we get the team together. It's a multidisciplinary team, so it's not just one person's opinion. We all get together to talk about somebody's situation before we make a recommendation as serious as a brain operation.